This week on Maker Update, an alarmingly capable hexapod, an LED kaleidoscope, a ChatGPT teddy bear, and a hackable pie watch. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool things makers are making. Hope you're doing well. I've got a lot of cool stuff to share. Let's get started with the project of the week. Check out this Arduino-powered hexapod by Acert Robotics. Not only is it an incredible and slightly terrifying robot, but the story behind its development is pretty amazing too. This robot was built from scratch in 3 months. The 3D printed design, the code, the custom remote control, everything. And unless there's something I'm not seeing here on his channel, this is his first robot. Granted, he has professional experience in coding and knows his way around Blender 3D design software thanks to his hobby in game development, so I don't feel too bad about myself. More than anything though, you can tell in the first minute of his overview video that Acert has an all-consuming obsession with hexapods. You don't do a project like this for funsies. I know this kind of project rapture, and I can tell you that this little demon was crawling around his head for who knows how long. In his ongoing playlist, you'll hear about how he tackled the mathematics of the unique hexapod gate, how he got all those servos to behave and not twitch, how he created his own PCB, got his robot to jump, attack, and switch into crab mode. It's really enjoyable to see how it all came together. With any luck, Acert will release the code and design files once he feels it's in a good place. Until then, I'll be eagerly checking back to see the progress. More projects! Deborah Ansell of Geek Mom Projects and Becky Stern have teamed up to create a project video for Deborah's 3D printed LED kaleidoscope. The really cool idea here is that Deborah is using wireless induction powered LEDs. These LEDs are encased in little 3D printed shapes that help to diffuse the light. And because they're wireless, they can freely shift around as you turn the end cap, just like a conventional kaleidoscope. You can find everything you need to make this project yourself by following the link in the description. On Adafruit, M. LeBlanc Williams has a guide on how to make your own AI animatronic teddy bear using a Raspberry Pi and ChatGPT. I mean, obviously we wouldn't want to bake artificial intelligence into something like that hexapod, but a teddy bear robot uprising seems somewhat manageable. And what really helps is that toy maker Gund already sells the animatronic bear. It just needs some hacking and a few extra parts to get up and running. Using this same formula, you could ChatGPT-ify all sorts of talking toys. Billy Bass, Grogu, Furbies, Twerking Santa. There's a ton of spin-off potential here. Now for some tips and tools. Have you ever thought about building your own digital watch using an RP2040 microcontroller? Well, it turns out that it's something you can already go out and buy. On Tindy, a seller called MakerGo is selling a fully assembled watch based on the RP2040. I hesitate to call it a smartwatch because I don't think there's any wireless connectivity going on here, but it is hackable. We know this because the good folks at Raspberry Pi tore one down, wrote new code for it, and even created their own 3D printed case. You can find a link to more details in the description. On YouTube, Jimmy DiResta has a great video covering 9 mistakes that beginners commonly make on the bandsaw. It's a great video and a great title, but it doesn't entirely account for all the uniquely DiResta bandsaw tips and techniques that are captured here. Not only is it entertaining, but it may save you a fingertip. Tim Hunkin is back with another Secret Life of Components video. This time, he's tackling a challenge every maker of every stripe has had to contend with, cutting holes. Big holes, tiny holes, holes in wood, holes in metal, holes in concrete. He looks at ancient tools, hand tools, electric tools, and what you need to keep those tools sharp. Back over on Adafruit, Aaron St. Blaine has a video and a written guide on tips and tricks for diffusing addressable LEDs. Dialing in the diffusion on an LED project really is the magic touch that takes something from looking like a blinking Christmas tree to a smooth, ethereal glow. There are a bunch of ways to accomplish it, from foams to fabrics, and Aaron covers them all. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, looking at all those hexapod servos got me curious about the selection of servos on DigiKey. Not only is it a great way to surface results and sort by size, torque, voltage, or RPM, but you're also gonna stumble across some unique options that you're just not gonna find on other sites. Here's a clutch servo made by DF Robot that, when blocked for 5 seconds, turns off and resets to avoid burning out. Here's a servo by Kitronic with alligator clips on the leads. Here's a high torque giant metal servo made by Hi-Tech. And if you ever wanted to know what a $750 commercial servo looks like, check out this beautiful all metal servo from Futaba. Whether you're looking for something specific or some surprising options you never knew existed, you can find it all on DigiKey. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Big thanks to DigiKey Electronics for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.